Welcome to this two-part video checklist for running a usability study. In this video, I'm going to cover a 10-point checklist for preparing for a usability test. Step number one, decide what you'd like to test and draft your research questions. This activity can be done with your team. Decide what you'd like to know and which part of the design you'd like your users to use and give you feedback on. For example, maybe you're working on updating some navigation, and you'd like to know if people can easily find content by using this new navigation. Step number two, decide who you need to recruit for your study. Maybe you need a mix of people, some people who are familiar with the current design and others who are new to the design. Or maybe you're going to focus on recruiting a specific persona for the next round of testing. In this step, it helps to make a list of inclusion and exclusion criteria. For example, an exclusion criterion might be someone who works in user experience or knows too much about the design. Step number three, create a screener questionnaire. To ensure we recruit the right people and not just people who want to participate in our study, we'll want to devise a questionnaire to screen out people who don't qualify for the study. Our screener questionnaire may include some distractor questions or options, so we don't give away who we're looking for. Step number four, create a consent form. Whenever we conduct any research study, it's important that people who participate in our research understand what the study is about and can make an informed choice about whether to take part. The consent form should contain details of the study, such as whether there will be people observing the session, whether the session will be recorded, and what participants will be asked to do during the session, and so on. Step number five, write tasks for your usability study. Tasks are what we give the user to direct their attention on the design. We may have 5 to 10 tasks for a 1-hour session. The number of tasks you will have for your session will depend on how long your session is and how involved each task is. Some tasks may only take a minute. Other tasks may take 10 minutes or more. Step number six, send your reminder emails. It's a good idea to remind participants about the session, especially if you've recruited them a week or more in advance. You can also send any important study information in this email, such as what participants might need for the session and whether there'll be any observers or recordings being made during the session. Step number seven, test your design. If you're using a prototype or testing a non-production environment, it's important to make sure everything works as it should. Otherwise, if things go wrong, it might be difficult to test your tasks properly and you'll lose precious time in the session trying to resolve technical issues. To test your design, run through all of your tasks and the relevant screens and functionality to see whether there are any issues. You may want to test across browsers and devices. If you're going to be testing on mobile, make sure to test your design on a mobile device. Step eight, consider running a pilot study. If you're running a large study or you have limited time to recruit further users, consider running a pilot test to make sure your tasks are understood and that you can get through the tasks in the allotted time. If not, consider prioritizing your tasks or setting a time cap for some tasks so you know when to stop the participant if they've spent long enough attempting a particular task. Step nine, prepare any observers. If you have observers joining your session, it's a good idea to tell them or remind them of basic observer etiquette. For example, they should arrive to the session in good time and not interrupt. You should also share with them your plan to collect any questions from them. For example, maybe you'll invite them to send their questions through a private chat channel for you to ask at the end of the session. You might also want your observers to take notes for you. If so, you might need to provide a template for them to take notes in, and perhaps some instructions on how to take helpful notes. Step 10. Gather all of your materials and information you need for the study and condense it into a facilitator guide. A facilitator guide usually includes the intro script you'll deliver at the beginning of the session, the tasks you will give your participant, and the questions you want to ask after each task or at the end of the session. You might also have some fake data or credentials that you will need to share with participants during the test, or perhaps a checklist of things that you need to remember to do. For example, making sure you gather their consent, press record, or ask the user to set up screen sharing if relevant. That's it. After these 10 steps, you should be ready to conduct your own usability study. Good luck.